Morning, everybody. Thank you so much. Thanks. You know, it's great to see so many of you back here. I see a few new faces in the crowd out there, too. Welcome. What an amazing year it's been for Palm, huh? Aside from the awards we won at CES last year, you know, we got the trifecta, including Best in Show. We also received some other really nice accolades. We were one of Popular Mechanics' 10 most brilliant products of 2009. And we were number one on T3's Hot 100 Gadgets of 2009. Last week, we got a Pogie. This week, Geeks of the Year. We've really appreciated all the positive buzz. And I want to spend a little time this morning giving you an update on what else we've accomplished in the last 12 months and what we've set out to do for the next year. When we designed WebOS, we made a very intentional bet on the web. The web plays a significant role in how we all live our lives today. It provides destinations and tools that help us stay informed, have fun, and be productive. And the web experience and the web community are at the heart of everything we do at Palm. We worked very, very hard on WebOS, and it's proven to be everything we imagined it could be, and more. And because it's based on JavaScript, HTML, and CSS, WebOS has allowed us to reach a very broad and accomplished development community. I believe we have some developers out here in the audience today, huh? Yeah? Yeah, all right. I know we're going to have some developers watching the replay on this thing, so I wanted to say, you know, thank you for your great support. We really appreciate it. Since we launched the WebOS SDK in July, we've had over 85,000 downloads from over 108 countries around the world. And in the 2 weeks since we launched Project Ares, that's our new online development environment, we've had over 20,000 registrations. These numbers are clear signals of significant early interest in our platform. And they're reflected in the number of applications already being developed, submitted, and distributed in our developer program, which we're opening to the public today. I'll have Katie Middick, our SVP of Product Marketing, come up and tell us a little bit more about this in a little while. But let's talk about Palm for a minute. At Palm, we care about two very fundamental things. First, keeping you connected. Connected to the people, information, experiences most important to you on the web. And second, making sure you never miss a thing. That's what drives us at Palm. And so far, we've delivered on these two promises in some powerful ways. For instance, our unique activity card UI allows you to multitask, keeping multiple applications and activities open at once, allowing things to happen in the background, and moving back and forth between activities whenever you want. Of course, there's everyone's favorite gesture, flicking that card off the screen when you're done. And our unique integration capabilities keep you from missing anything. Synergy connects your data in multiple places in the cloud. It also keeps your information automatically up to date, even across different applications. And notifications keep you informed and give you peace of mind, without interruption. At last year's show, we introduced the Pre. The Pre is a great example of that Palm experience. Processing power, a vivid touchscreen, and a physical keyboard, all tightly integrated into one refined and elegant package that keeps you on top of the important things that happen throughout your day. And now we have two devices in our growing family that deliver this remarkable Palm experience. We introduced Pixie in mid-November. Not only does it deliver the same WebOS experience as the Pre, it's the thinnest, lightest, full QWERTY touchscreen smartphone on the market. And it's the perfect choice for consumers looking to purchase their first smartphone. Now, we know how much people like to have choices. So with Pixie, we've added some new ways to let you express yourselves. Our design team has selected and worked with some really talented artists and developed a collection of interchangeable, limited edition artist series back covers. This one's Hummingbird by the artist Cole Gerst. And here's our first family of designs. Pretty cool, huh? These have been really popular. Now, we've limited production to only a few thousand per design. Once they're gone, they'll never be available again. So get them while they're hot. In addition to these, we have another set of artists lined up for future designs. So you'll have a continual flow of cool back covers that you can use to personalize your Pixie. And let's not forget another one of our impressive industry firsts, the Touchstone Charging Dock, the world's most advanced phone charger. Each Artist Series back cover features Touchstone technology built right in. Simply install your back cover, place it on the Touchstone Charging Dock, and your phone charges on contact. Touchstone also transforms the experience of the product itself. It's more than just a phone charger. Use it to charge and go hands-free, watch movies, present incoming notifications, or as a bedside alarm clock like I do. I actually have three of them in my apartment. And from our growing family of products, we move to our growing family of partners that are helping us expand our distribution around the globe. This all started with the great launch we had with Sprint. And we're very fortunate to be working with strong and enthusiastic partners in each of our markets. Pre can now be found in 7 countries worldwide. And the products have been well received. But hey, don't take my word for it. We have a short video I'd like to share with you from a few of the countries in Europe where we introduced the Palm experience over the past few months. So let's go ahead and watch that now.
Yeah, I mean, the European consumer is really just beginning to embrace the mobile internet and understanding really what that means and what that can bring to their life.
I think what's clear in Europe now, and we've been waiting for it probably for 4 or 5 years, is that the age of the mobile internet has come.
We used to talk about ubiquity when it came to voice, but it's really there from a data point of view. And I think what we're seeing, if I can be bold, is we're seeing the death of the PC.
We want to be seen as a global player. We believe in order to deliver true shareholder value, we need to be a global player.
We're going into Europe. This is a new endeavor for the Pre. We're going to have products that come behind it, and we're going to be there for a really long time.
So we've really got to try and re-establish that brand and actually what it stands for.
The first step was finding a great partner who could really understand how we could introduce this product in a unique way and bring it to life.
From our perspective, one of the most important things is we're very picky and choosy about who we create relationships with.
We were looking for a partner who knew how to win and wanted to win.
We gave it real prominence throughout our windows and in store. Actually, there's a clear bay and an area that Palm Pre will be sold from that's Palm branded. What we try to do is really be very focused on the individual customer needs.
Yeah, and selling these products is a challenge. They're complicated devices that have an incredible amount of functionality and power behind them.
Das heißt, es wird angezeigt, da ist ein Update, Sie müssen nur auf jetzt installieren klicken und schon kann's losgehen.
Cerrar alguna de las aplicaciones, simplemente la lanza.
What they've been able to do in terms of how a customer shops for smartphones and these new breed of devices has been extraordinary.
We've been selling it now for 2 months. Our customers are very excited, and our competition are nervous.
I think together we can really do some good business and bring some great experiences to a lot of customers.
You know, it's been an exciting time for us. As you can see, we've been working really hard in Europe. And today, we're going to announce a new European partner. As we look for other opportunities to complement our efforts in Germany, the UK, Ireland, and Spain, an obvious choice for us was France, due to the size and sophistication of the market. And I like the wine there, too. We found an excellent partner in SFR. They've been investing heavily in the latest 3G technologies that will deliver the rich Palm experience across France. And they're motivated to win the hearts and minds of consumers as they increase market share and grow their product portfolio. Palm will help them do just that by bringing Pre and Pixie to SFR in the second quarter. To explain a little bit more about this unique partnership, we've invited Jean-Marc Tissetto, Senior Executive VP of Consumer, Brand, and Marketing at SFR to join us on stage today. So everyone, please give a warm welcome to Jean-Marc.
Thank you. Good morning. We have a slight preference for red wine, including the Napa Valley red wine of last night. Who are we? We are a 12 billion euros turnover company owned by both Vivendi and Vodafone. We have the luck to have two strong, stable, though demanding, shareholders. We have 25 million customers. We are a fully integrated fixed plus mobile company, 20 million mobile customers with really high ARPU, and 5 million customers on fixed and broadband propositions. Our reach is half of the French population. We are also known to be a very innovative company. We are the first one to introduce the 3G technology on the French market. In November 2004, we invented multi-layer mobile tariff plans named Illimitix with fully unlimited data plans included. We are also deploying the fiber to provide main French households with up to 100 megs broadband proposition. Our purpose there and our objective is in 2012 to have half of our customers equipped with smartphones. So that's the challenge for us. 10 million SFR customers equipped with smartphones. So our mission is to provide those customers, our customers, with the best smartphones in the world. We started the year 2009 negotiating some smartphones in Cupertino. We ended in Sunnyvale. So, just to let you know that we go where are the best smartphones in the world. Why did we choose Palm? First, we know that the Palm brand awareness is still very high in France. There is a specific Palm situation with over 70% of our customers knowing Palm, and we know that there is a very positive buzz around the brand, around the products. Second, the products. I won't talk about the products. You will see the demo. We are very enthusiastic about what we saw. We are really certain that those products will find the right targets, either young experts or professionals or big corporations. You will see the demo. It's just amazing. And last but not least, we believe that we share the same philosophy. At the end of the day, it's not all about selling devices or selling tariff plans. It's just all about a customer experience as simple, as exciting as possible. Why did Palm choose us? We are quite good as far as go-to-market operations are concerned, and this is not only typical French arrogance, what I'm saying. We own 800 shops. We have sent last year in 2009 over 1 billion messages to our customers, to the base, so we know a lot about CRM. We have developed highly segmented operations on the base, so we can provide our strategic partner, Palm, with a strong go-to-market strength. And while I'm talking there, we are in the CES convention in Paris with all the CES force, and we are telling to those guys that we are committing very strongly with Palm as a strategic partner. So at the end of the day, our intention is on the road to those 50% of the base equipped with the best smartphones in the world, is to be strong, reliable partners to Palm in order to have this Palm revival story on the French market as efficient as possible. So thank you for listening. I have to take my flight back to Paris, which is true, in order to prepare the operations. We have strong pressure from Palm, but we'll be there. Thanks for listening and see you in Paris. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Jean-Marc. Thank you, Jean-Marc. Have a safe flight home. We couldn't be more thrilled with how the partnership is unfolding. Our teams have been working together closely, laying the foundation for a long-lasting and meaningful relationship. You know, I'm personally looking forward to heading over to Paris for that launch event. Now let's get back to some products. I'd like to introduce Katie Middick, our SVP of Product Marketing. Katie and her teams have been responsible for designing and building our developer program and bringing new thinking to every product experience we deliver. And she's got some great stuff to show you today. So everyone, please welcome Katie.
Thanks, John, and hello, everyone. I'm excited to be here today to talk to you about two things. First, the Palm Developer Program, and second, some exciting new product developments. So first, today, after 6 months in a closed private beta with some fantastic application partners, we're formally opening our developer program. What this means is that any developer... It is very exciting! What this means is that any developer is now free to submit their WebOS application to Palm for distribution in any of the 7 markets that we do business. We look forward to working with you. Now, our platform and our program have 3 distinct advantages. First, we have a very fast and easy development cycle. Second, we provide groundbreaking integration opportunities. And third, we give developers freedom and choice in how they take their applications to market. Now, we partner with some incredible application partners all over the world, and we're incredibly thankful to those who have helped us reach this critical milestone today, especially including our friends in the homebrew community who are graduated now into the Palm App catalog. Thank you. So even inside this private beta, we've had some impressive results. Let's take a look. In August, we gave key developers access to our platform and our program to develop and distribute applications to the WebOS community. In that program alone, over the last 3 months, we've increased applications over 10 times to over 1,000 applications. And now, of course, with the opening of our program, we expect that to grow even more and faster. And in December, we announced Project Ares. Project Ares is an innovative application development environment hosted entirely in the browser. It makes WebOS application development even more accessible and embodies our belief that the future of mobile is going to be built on the web. So with the opening of our program today and innovative tools like Project Ares, we look forward to some incredible growth in our application catalog this year. Now, what's great for our customers is that all these applications work together. WebOS provides a new level of integration opportunity not afforded on any other platform. So no longer are applications siloed packages of utility or entertainment. Instead, applications share data, they share content, they share services, they bring it all together in one integrated, seamless experience for our customers. So if you're using LinkedIn or Facebook on a Palm device, you can integrate your contacts from those services seamlessly into your global address book. Or baseball fans enjoy our sporting baseball application from Zumobi to follow their favorite teams. They can integrate their game schedules into their personal calendar, and they get great real-time alerts and notifications as things are happening during the game. We're very proud to be delivering these integrated experiences with some fantastic partners, people like Google, Yahoo, Facebook, LinkedIn, and many, many more. They're helping us build connected, integrated experiences that make sure our customers never miss a thing. Now, you heard me mention that freedom and choice that we're offering developers and how they take their applications to market. And with the launch of our program today, we're taking a completely new approach to application distribution. Developers are always looking for more and better distribution for their applications. Consumers are always looking for better, more efficient ways to find the applications that are right for them. And certainly, we've watched the web develop as an incredibly large and efficient channel for connecting consumers with content and applications that are relevant to them. So why wouldn't we leverage the tools and the community of the web to do the same for Palm applications? And today we are. We're opening up our database of application information. Descriptions, ratings, reviews, downloads, stats, application URLs. We're opening it up to all of our developers. In fact, we're opening it up to the entire web community to help us build the mechanisms to connect consumers and developers. So starting today, you can build directories, create ranking mechanisms, build gadgets, widgets, Facebook and tweet your favorite applications to your heart's content. If you can imagine it, we're going to give you the tools and the access to build it. We want developers to have as much freedom as choice in developing and distributing their applications. And we want consumers to have lots of choices in how they find those applications. And I'd like to walk you through an example. This is Project Appetite. It's an online directory of WebOS applications built by our developer relations team that we'll be open sourcing to the community today. So I can surf on this website and find interesting applications. This Paratroopers one looks really interesting. It's got 5 stars. Over 200 people have rated it. I can click on more info. I'm on a website. I just click on more info to get more information about it. It looks pretty interesting. If I want that application, I simply click install, get prompted for my phone number. Moments later, I get a notification to my device. Simply tap, see the application, tap to install, and it's done. Over the air, that easy. I found a great application on the web. Within moments, I have it on my device, and I'm enjoying it. More freedom for developers, more choices for consumers is just going to put less distance between the two, and that's just better for everyone. Now, we know discoverability is a big challenge, and that was an important part of our motivation for the openness of our program. We really believe that providing the feeds and the mechanisms and the data for developers to build their own marketplaces and their own mechanisms for connecting their applications with the best customers will just make their businesses better. And today, we're putting our money where our mouth is. We're introducing the Hot Apps Bonus Program. The Hot Apps Bonus Program offers $1 million in cash incentives to the developers who get the best distribution as measured by downloads for both free and paid applications from February through May. So now developers are going to have everything in their hands to control their destiny. A great platform, tools, open distribution, so that they can connect with their customers and build their business. We look forward to seeing what they're going to do with it. Now, that's not all. We realize developers always want more, including more opportunity to create rich mobile experiences. That's why today, we're announcing the Palm WebOS Plugin Development Kit. This plugin development kit, which we affectionately call the PDK, extends the capabilities of WebOS so that developers can build plugins for their WebOS applications. So now, developers can integrate C and C++ code into their WebOS applications, enabling new categories of functionality. We expect plugins are going to play an important role in the evolution of the WebOS platform, just as they have for web browsers, and similarly, that the functionality of the plugins will be incorporated to the core SDK over time. Now, given the great demand we've heard from consumers and developers alike for 3D games on our platform, we've decided to focus there first. We'll be releasing the PDK in March at the Game Developer Conference, and we hope to see you all there. But of course, in advance of that release, we've been working with some fantastic early access partners to develop rich, immersive games for our platform. And I'm pleased to announce that today, we will have hot new game titles available in the Palm App Catalog. All of these games take advantage of our PDK and come from fantastic partners like Laminar Research, Gameloft, EA Mobile, and Glue Mobile. Fantastic 3D games like EA's Need for Speed and Sims 3, Let's Golf from Gameloft and Glider from Glue Mobile, and other popular titles like Sudoku and Scrabble. Available in the US today for Palm Pre customers in the Palm App Catalog. So now, if you're a gamer, you know EA, but you might not know that they are the worldwide leader in mobile gaming. They've been a fantastic partner to us, have really worked very hard with us to bring the PDK to life, and we're excited to have some of their fantastic titles on our platform today. So we've invited Travis Boatman, head of Worldwide Studios, here to tell you more. Please join me in welcoming Travis.
Thanks, Katie. Thank you. Thanks, Katie. Hey, everybody. So Electronic Arts is mostly known for its high quality and world-class games. We also have one of the most diverse portfolio of games out there. And the goal of that is to really have something for everybody, particularly when it comes to mobile consumers. There's really all kinds of consumers out there. So we've got family games, music games, racing games, sports games, a whole bunch of different stuff. Now, just a few months ago, when the Palm folks came to us and asked us to partner with them on the plugin development kit to bring some of these great games to their platform, we couldn't have been more excited. Without going into too much detail about the whole development process, within just a few weeks, we really realized how great this SDK is. It had great APIs. For example, excellent accelerometer, excellent touchscreen, and they were really well suited, among others, for gameplay. Second was great performance. We've got some really performance-intensive games, and it was great to see these things up and running on the device at a great frame rate. And third, it was really easy to use. Again, like these high-performance games, we've got really complex games that really push the limits of these devices. 3D games that do touchscreen and accelerometer, networking, music, all at the same time. And we were able to have those things up and running in just a few weeks. Funny enough, while we were doing some of this work, some of the information got out a little bit earlier than we would have liked. But what it showed us was that consumers didn't think this was even possible. And so we're here to show you today that it is possible, and this stuff's for real. So the first one we'd like to show you is The Sims 3. Now, The Sims 3 is one of the world's largest gaming franchises that sold over 100 million units worldwide. As you can see here, we've created a nice immersive Sims experience. Rick's demoing for us, and he's made a little character here with jeans and camo shirt and a mohawk. I think he's living vicariously through our character's hair here, because he doesn't have quite that look. You can also see Rick's designed his house and customized his house the way he sees fit. So he's added, you know, a stereo there in the background, because he's a music lover. He's got a refrigerator and a television. That's important to The Sims game, because your character goes out in the world, and it has a job, and it comes home, and it's nice to have a nice, entertaining home to live in. But we're not constrained to just live in the house. We can also take our characters outside. We're only giving you a really small taste of this game. This game has over 70 objectives, a big world you can explore, and a whole bunch of things you can do. In fact, you see here Rick exploring his deviant side by wrecking his yard. And that's kind of my cue to get us to the next demo. So I hope you guys liked what you saw with Sims 3. So clearly, the next game we're going to show you is Need for Speed. Now, Need for Speed is the world's largest racing franchise. And this game is going to be exciting, because it's really going to show you what we can do on this device in pushing the performance. And what you can see here is Rick's favorite car, the Nissan GTR. What we're going to do first is we're going to customize the look of the car and show you all the different things you can do even before you race. So here we're using the touchscreen to move around through the world. Rick is using the touchscreen to simply drag his fingers up and down and change the color in real time. Right, really cool. We're going with this bright red so we can see the modifications we made later in the game. The next thing we're going to do is customize performance. So Rick's now just tapping right on the screen. He's changing the spoiler on the back. Let's go with that one. That looks good. It's kind of low profile. And what's interesting about these modifications is they're not just cosmetic. This actually affects gameplay, right? So this spoiler will change the way the car performs. Here you can see Rick selecting different challenges. There's a whole host of challenges we can choose from, but we're just going to choose a quick straight race, right? Something just to get us into the demo. Now what you're going to see next is that red car that we just modified with that new spoiler and that nice red color. Now again, this is all running in real time, in full 3D, on the plugin SDK. And it looks gorgeous. And it's running, again, at a really, really phenomenal frame rate. Now as Rick's driving, you're going to notice he's using the accelerometer, right? So he's tilting this thing back and forth. And the reason we use the accelerometer for a game like Need for Speed is because we want to keep the screen clear of any obstructions, so that as the action's happening, you're not covering it up with your finger. So let's show you what some of this stuff looks like. And let's push the limits of the Palm by hitting our Nitro. Good driving, Rick. Yeah. Thanks. So that's pretty impressive. We hope you like what you see and what you can do with the Palm Pre and really pushing the performance. So Need for Speed, Sims 3, and a whole bunch of other games are available by EA on the store today, and hope you like what you saw. Thanks, everybody.
Thanks a lot. That was awesome. That Need for Speed with Nitro always gets the adrenaline running. So thank you very much, Travis, to you and your teams for helping us bring this PDK to life and bringing these hot new titles to our catalog today. But that's not all. We have more exciting things to share with you about the WebOS platform. So I'd like to invite you to help me welcome Paul Cousineau, Director of Software Product Marketing from Palm, to the stage to share more news now.
Thank you, Katie. Hello, everybody. Now, Katie, can I get a little pose for the camera, please?
Sure.
Excellent. Thank you. Let me just hand this off. One of the best things about WebOS is its ability to evolve and grow. Our over-the-air software updates have added significant new features and performance enhancements since we first shipped in June. Today, I'd like to talk to you about a great new feature that many of you, especially all you with all the cameras, are going to have a lot of fun with, video recording. I figured that one would be a hit. Figure what better way to demonstrate this new feature than to actually show you how you can record, edit, and share video on WebOS. Here's the video we just took of Katie. There we are, we're gonna get the pose. Excellent. Pretty good shot except for the part where I pointed at my feet. So let me show you just how easy it is to edit video. I simply tap this button and we bring up a timeline with little thumbnails of the video. I simply drag the handles. Let's get back to the pose. Perfect. Press this button to confirm my selection. And voila, a shorter video. Now, to share my new masterpiece, I simply tap up top. I'm presented with a number of options. I can upload to YouTube or to Facebook. I could send this as an attachment to an email. Or I could share it via MMS. Let's select YouTube. Here we are. I could tag it. I can put it in a category, or I simply press this button, and off it goes in the background. So there you are, real-time example of capturing, editing, and sharing video on WebOS. Now, I got even better news in that this great new capture, edit, and share experience will be available to all WebOS customers via a software update coming in February. No new hardware required. This is a powerful example of how our over-the-air updates keep giving customers new reasons to love their phones. Now, Travis and Rick did a great job showing us the experience that can be enabled by our plugin development kit. What I'd like to show you is how these games integrate into WebOS so you can easily move between activities. We were exploring the Sims 3 world earlier. Let's head back over there to see an example of this unique integration. Here we are. I have this character, Jonathan, that I've taken to the park. Now, there aren't any trash cans at the park, but there are other good things to do. And there's people that come up and bug you every once in a while, so we have to tolerate that. We have a stranger, maybe make an acquaintance. Good. We're now friends with Ruth. One of the things you can do at the park is you can go fishing. Press on this fish hook. Now, fishing is one of these little accelerometer-based mini-games that lets me move back and forth to catch some fish. Now, see this text down here? This is an instant message from Mark. He cleanly overlays the game and then fades away to the dashboard. So I deal with it when I'm ready. We'll leave our fish here for a second. We'll head out to card view. See how my game neatly pauses? The fish is right next to that hook. I tap down here in the dashboard. I see that I have a couple of things going on. The YouTube video is now finished uploading, and I have that message from Mark, who is obviously not paying attention to my schedule. Maybe he is, and he's helping me out. Let me answer Mark. Demo. There we are. Took care of him. Now, back to fishing. See it? Oops. See how we go back exactly to where we were before? We can actually go back and try and catch the fish. Now Mark wants to go to a movie. That does sound interesting. So I can tap directly on that and go right there. So my game neatly pauses again in the background. If I'm focused on the game, I just let the message go to the dashboard. If something I want to act on comes in, I can go right there. This intelligent integration of games with the Palm experience is another great example of how we make sure you're always connected and never missing a thing. I could definitely handle a movie tonight, and Mark has conveniently sent me a link to this trailer. We'll see if it's the one that I want to go see. This lets me go over to the browser to see another great development on our platform, which is our support for Adobe's Flash 10. This is Flash 10, a technology that's core to so many of your web experiences on the desktop. Now, often on a device like this, you just get a puzzle piece or a blank square. But with our support for the plugin, you get something that's a lot more interesting, something a little more like this.
You Jake Sully? I'd like to talk to you about a fresh start on a new world. You'd be making a difference.
These Yahoo movie trailers are one of the many different pieces of media content you'll now be able to access on the browser on any pre. We go out to card view, and the trailer neatly pauses. Pre-customers will be able to download a beta of the plugin from the app catalog soon, providing yet another example of how our connected experience keeps making the products you already own better and better. We have one more item waiting for us in the dashboard. We were looking at it earlier. It was when the YouTube link that said it's up there now. Now, our dashboard can do more than just keep you up to date. You can take quick actions right from here. What good's a YouTube video unless people know it's there? I simply tap on this link again, and I have a number of options to share that link with people. So I could send it via SMS, or I could promote it as an email and over a link. But we can also take advantage of our strong integration with Facebook. So with one button press, here I am posting it to my Facebook status. So now all my friends can see the real-time masterpiece that I created. These are some of the great enhancements we're bringing to the webOS platform. Awesome 3D games that not only deliver an unparalleled experience in terms of graphics performance, but also integrate with the core elements of webOS so you can cleanly move back and forth between activities. A software update that's providing an awesome capture, edit, and share experience for customers so that you guys can create and share memories using the devices you already own. And last but not least, Flash plugin for the pre-browser, making the webOS browsing experience richer than ever. Thank you, everybody, and I'll hand it back to Katie.
Thank you, Paul. And those are just some more great examples of the continuing innovation you'll keep seeing from Palm. Now, you heard me mention those over-the-air software updates. I'd like to talk about those for a moment. They're really awesome. They give us the capability to put new functionality in our customers' hands even after they have their devices. What's best is that customers don't need to do a thing. The updates come in the background, over the air. All it takes is a simple install to get that great new experience. And we've brought 9 software updates since June, more than one a month. We've brought enhanced synergy support for Yahoo and LinkedIn. We've added battery and performance improvements. We've enhanced our support of EAS. We've added email search. We've made numerous app catalog improvements, including the addition of commerce, and many, many, many more. In fact, it's fitting that the notification for a software update comes as a gift box on your device, because it always makes your experience better. And when you see that little gift icon, you know there's something special coming from us to you. And we're bringing the pace of web development to the mobile environment. Let's face it, the web doesn't wait for annual keynotes and quarterly rollouts. We're constantly adding new partners all across the web and innovating on our experience. And we don't want you to have to wait long to get the benefits of that. So look for that software update coming in February. It'll have more great battery and performance improvements. And it'll have that great video capability that Paul just demoed for you. This is all great evidence of the continuing things that we'll deliver to our customers to get them surprised and delighted about our experience. So all of today's announcements, the opening of our developer program, the Hot Apps Bonus Program, the WebOS PDK, hot new 3D game titles, video capabilities, Flash 10 browser plugin support, are all great examples of our continuing commitment to provide a great experience full of freedom and choice to developers and consumers alike, and our continuing commitment to help you live your web-enabled life, your web-connected life, seamlessly, easily, effortlessly, so that you don't miss a thing. So thank you very much, and I'd like to invite John back to share some more exciting things that are happening at Palm. Please join me in welcoming John.
Thanks, Katie. What'd you think? Great, huh? Yeah, good stuff. Yeah. So as you can see, we've been hard at work building new products, innovations, and features, and we have a lot more in the pipeline. In fact, today, we're announcing two new products. First, the Pre Plus. We updated the product design on the Pre Plus, and one of the things we did was remove the navigation button. So now it's a more elegant and easy to use experience. We doubled the internal memory, so you get increased performance, and you can do more complicated tasks, like those 3D games we showed you. Pre Plus comes with 16 gigabytes of flash memory to allow you to store more of your important stuff, like videos, photos, music, applications, whatever. And it comes now with an inductive back cover, so it's touchstone ready right out of the box. Just get yourself a touchstone charger, and you're good to go. Second, we're introducing Pixie Plus. The Pixie Plus is incredibly thin and lightweight. And unlike the previous version of Pixie, Pixie Plus features built-in Wi-Fi, so you can jump on your home network or grab a hotspot for a faster connection. Pixie Plus is the perfect choice for those who want to make the transition from a feature phone to their first smartphone. And you know what? I love using it too, as do some other members of our executive staff. So you should go try one out. With the Pixie Plus, we're introducing more choices for back cover so you can personalize your Pixie. Here's our new colors. Of course, these all work great with the touchstone charging dock. Now, Katie talked to you a little bit more about how important it is that our customers have choices. And I want to say a little bit more about that. We know that people also want to have their choice of carrier. So we've been working hard to build some new partnerships. And today, we're proud to announce that these two new phones, Pre Plus and Pixie Plus, will be available exclusively on the Verizon Wireless Network. We're also announcing a new application exclusive to Pre Plus and Pixie Plus. And that's the Palm Mobile Hotspot. It turns your Pre Plus or Pixie Plus into an intelligent mobile hotspot. It's really, really cool. It takes tethering to a whole new level, completely wireless. Let's say you need internet access for your notebook far away from a traditional hotspot. Just download the Mobile Hotspot application from the Palm App Catalog. Install it on your device. Add the appropriate feature to your voice and data plan. And you'll have high-speed internet connection in moments. And you can support up to 5 total connections. You don't need anything more than the phone you already carry in your pocket. So I'd like to share a short message from John Stratton, CMO of Verizon Wireless. Now, we plan to have him here live via satellite from a team meeting, but due to some bad weather, we had to get him to record this a few hours ago. So please, welcome John.
Hello, John. Thanks for inviting me to your news conference today. I'd love to be with you live, but we woke up to quite a storm today in Chicago. I'm traveling with the Verizon Wireless leadership team this week, speaking to employees across the country as we kick off 2010. As you know, we've been sharing with employees the facts around our upcoming launch of the Palm Pre Plus and the Pixie Plus. We think this is a great way to kick off the new year. We're looking forward to offering customers 2 outstanding smartphones that get new life on America's largest 3G network. So today we're announcing that on January 25th, Verizon Wireless customers will be able to buy 2 great new smartphones, the Pre Plus and the Pixie Plus. Now, John's already told you about these new devices, great new designs, added features and functionality, increased memory, but at Verizon, we're most excited about the 3G mobile hotspot capability these devices offer. The Pre Plus and the Pixie Plus will be the world's first devices to provide this capability. Customers will be able to connect up to 5 different Wi-Fi-enabled devices to the web through their Pre Plus or Pixie Plus. We think this takes this to a whole new level. Okay, so let's see. You've heard about the features. You've certainly heard that the Pre Plus and Pixie Plus will be on the nation's most reliable network. So there's really only one missing piece. How much will they cost? I suspect you won't be surprised that we're not here to announce the pricing of these devices today. We're going to wait until we get a little closer to the January 25th availability date. But John, hey, thanks again for inviting me to join you. Your team really is doing some great work. Now, as I mentioned before, I'm in Chicago today. Great planning, in the middle of January. There's a foot of snow falling here, so I'm going to hightail it out of here. But I'm looking forward to our continuing relationship and our adding more great devices to our portfolio in the future.
Well, we really appreciate John being with us today, even if it was virtually. And John, when you're watching this, thanks for joining us. We really appreciate it. And it's great to see that he's meeting with the Verizon Wireless team and getting them nice and fired up about Pre Plus and Pixie Plus. Now, we're all very, very excited about this relationship, as you can tell. And we're looking forward to building a long-lasting partnership together. Well, as you can see, the teams have been really busy lately. No time for hammocks this last year. Now, let's recap some of the announcements we made today. Palm and SFR. Our global expansion continues with our partnership with SFR, bringing the Palm experience to consumers across France. We'll launch in the second quarter. Katie opened the doors to our full developer program. Not only does it provide more freedom for developers when they're building and distributing applications, but it also creates more ways to bring consumers and developers together. More choices, more freedom for you. The developer program is open today, and we're now taking application submissions. So get your applications in. We showed you some great new 3D games from EA, Glu Mobile, Gameloft, Laminar. Titles like Tetris, Monopoly, Glider, Let's Golf, Oregon Trail, and my personal favorite, Need for Speed. You know, I've been testing this, and I can't put it down. Of course, I can't get past the third level, and I just got a little hint in the back there of how to get through the third level, so I'm going to try it later today. These all take advantage of our new capabilities of our WebOS plugin development kit, and they look really fantastic on the Pre. Now, I know you couldn't download them during the keynote. Probably some of you were trying. We wanted you all paying attention. All right? But they're available now in the US on the Palm App Catalog, so go download them right away. And you know, maybe we can play a little Monopoly during that up-and-coming Intel keynote. Paul came up here and showed you the new video recording feature. We're going to deliver it over the air for free to every Pre and Pixie on the planet. And we'll get it out to you in February with our WebOS 1.4 release. So look for that little gift box. We also showed you the new Adobe Flash browser plugin. This is the first time that Flash, we're not talking flashlight, this is the real thing, has been available on a mobile device. The Flash 10 beta plugin will be available in the app, in the Palm App Catalog soon, and it'll work on any Pre with the WebOS 1.4 update. We introduced you to our newest phones, Pre Plus and Pixie Plus. These are the most advanced phones Palm has ever made, and they'll both be available starting January 25th, exclusively through our newest carrier partner, Verizon Wireless. Our partnership with Verizon Wireless is just another way we're creating freedom for our customers. And I really like the mobile hotspot too. It's a cool way to use your phone, and we have a lot more cool stuff planned for the future. So I'd like to invite you all to join us for food and drinks in the Palm Lounge to see this stuff up close. We'll even let you hold it yourself this time. We're in room N246 in the Convention Center on the second floor. For those of you here last year, it's the same place. And we hope to see you up there either later today or we'll be there throughout the week. As I said, we've been busy this last year. At the last CES, I told you Palm was back. And we meant it. The entire Palm team has been working extraordinarily hard to deliver this amazing platform and these innovative products. I'd like to take a moment to thank everyone at Palm, including all those people busy watching on our satellite link, as well as our many partners for the critical role they've played in our success. Could we have a round of applause for them, please? Yeah. We look forward to growing the company in 2010. But as we grow, we promise to stay focused on keeping you connected to the most important people and information in your life, so you'll never miss a thing. We will continue to surprise and delight you. So stay tuned. And thank you all so much for coming today. We really appreciate it. Thank you.